from both as an artist and as a gallery. And I feel as though my art practice has benefited a great deal from having that experience of working in galleries, so that, as Jenny and Francis were saying, it really gives you an insight into what galleries are looking for and how best to approach them. I did, throughout school, voluntary work at a film workshop. I did an internship at Shaws of Dallas, and then after graduating went on to do a 6-month voluntary internship at the sculpture studios. And all of them have fed into my understanding of the art world, and really has helped me establish myself within the art scene. I think that it is that I'm very aware that it is difficult to be able to fund yourself when you are on internships, but it's a lot of hard work, but it is worth doing, and even if it means, you know, having jobs in the evening on weekends, like, it won't last forever, and it is an excellent way to start. I think it's important also to think about, when you are working with galleries, the different ways in which an exhibition can come about, and the different circumstances that you as an artist will be put under. Degree Show is a public exhibition, but it's unlike any other exhibition that you'll have. But it's really important to learn a lot from your experience at Degree Show. You know, the press, organizing with the peers that share the room that you're installing in, all of that is things, building up skills that you'll have to use when you do have your own show out of DSA. And also, you know, group shows with your peers when you're still a student. You know, negotiating space and how you deal with doing flyers and all the organisation that goes behind putting on a show. That's something that you can be doing whilst you're a student, and really learn from that and make sure that then you reflect upon what worked and what didn't. And that's really key. Group exhibitions will obviously be different to having a solo show. You know, there's a lot more negotiation with space and what work you're going to put and how the works respond to each other's sound, and all of these kind of issues will come up when you're having a group show. Whereas a solo show, it will be more perhaps negotiating with the gallery, just that relationship, whereas the group show will be the gallery, your other artists, and yourself. There's also exhibiting with a given theme, so there may be an open submission where, you know, the theme is such and such, and you propose a work relating to that theme. There may be an open submission where there's no theme, and you just propose a work. You may be, for example, a member of Transmission, and therefore get a show, or get a piece of work in a member show. So all of these are different ways of getting exhibitions, and how you then negotiate with the gallery will differ. I think it's really important from the onset, when you are working with galleries, to get an understanding of what the gallery expects of you, what you expect from the gallery. If you don't have this at the beginning, then you could come into some major problems. I realised, having worked from galleries, that really they have very minimal budgets, and so in terms of payment, you may be looking at next to nothing, if anything at all. But what often you can tap into is their press, their contact. contacts, you know, use their mailing list. You need to establish whether they've got any equipment that you can borrow, you know, or hire or use. And if not, whether they'll hire it for you, whether they'll help with the installation of work, whether they want to install it for you. I was involved in a show at the RSA in Edinburgh, and they actually had a huge team of installers who really had said, drop off your work and then they'll install it for you, which was a huge shock for me because I'd always been, you know, on the day installing it myself. And actually, I then had to negotiate with them to be able to install it myself because it was a site-specific work. And that brought in a whole load of other things that I had to consider, you know, drawing maps of how it was that I was going to install it. But that negotiation with them, that I couldn't give that information until I in my space because it was site specific. So if I hadn't have had those negotiations from the beginning, then I would have maybe just had to hand all the work over when they install it and it'd be a completely different work. So it is really important to get that communication going at the beginning. The exhibition preview, if they are going to offer the opening, do you have to pay the drinks? Do you have to contribute to the money that will go towards that? That's not unusual. It comes into money drink commitments. Also, thinking about whether the gallery will charge commission if you do happen to sell anything. What is the commission rate? Now, it's a horrid situation to be in if you suddenly sell a piece of work and then you haven't even thought about what the gallery takes, and then the gallery says, we take 50% commission and we price your work at £10, and you realise, oh, that leaves me with £5 and the materials cost £10. You know, you've got whether you are going to be charged commission will have an impact on your prices if you do intend to sell. So all this should be ironed out at the beginning. If there's invigilation, do they provide invigilation? Will you have to be there every day? Will you have to open up? Will you have to switch on your work? You know, all of these questions to be asked, because the last thing that you want is to have an exhibition and for you not to be there, for the work not to be switched on, or, you know, someone not know how to switch it on. So you must try and think of all of these factors prior to putting on your show. One experience that I had that I'd like to talk to you about was this was my video installation that I showed at the Glee Show, and following that I then got offered to take part in an exhibition down in Leeds, and they requested specifically that I install that piece of work. Now, I said from the onset that that wasn't possible. The television monitors cost £200 each, there was no budget. I couldn't afford to hire 3 television monitors at £600 when I just graduated with a huge student debt. They weren't going to pay for insurance of the monitors, which, having researched all of that, cost thousands of pounds, you know. The transport of the work, if I had to transport these monitors from Glasgow because I couldn't source them in Leeds, that would add another amount to my no fee, you know. So it just wasn't possible. And from the onset, I was very aware that this could not be replicated. However, they kept demanding that that was the work that was chosen, etc. And it really became a problem, and I must admit, I did not enjoy that exhibition whatsoever. I had 3 days to install it, and on the third day, had to make like major compromises. And even though I was well aware from the beginning of all the issues, and I negotiated with them, it does happen that that some curators and some galleries are really hard to work with. And in the end, this wasn't what I installed. I wasn't pleased with it because there were numerous things about it that I had considered and for my degree show controlled, such as the colour of the wall, you know, it was reflected, the sound, it was a public building, so they didn't enjoy having the sound, whereas the sound was part of the work. All of this that I informed them from the beginning, it was almost like they hadn't thought about what they were signing up for. So that's just one example of things do happen that are unpleasant experiences, but you learn from them, and I know that I would have actually refused the opportunity of having that show had I known the amount of stress that I would save, actually. This was what I was talking about with regards to the RSA exhibition. This is a shot of the installation that I did, and I really would advise you that anything throughout your development of the work that you're going to do. I got informed about the show a year before the actual show, and so had a year to develop the work, and obviously at the beginning didn't know what I was going to show, but then it is important nearer the time when you get more ideas just to keep feeding back to the gallery, you know, oh, I'm going to do an installation. Sizes, dimensions, all these practical considerations, because they need to bear this in mind when curating the show, when knowing where to put you. So, I mean, don't send them an email every day saying I've decided to change the colour of the sky from light blue to dark blue. You know, that's not really going to help them, and it's not going to put you in a favourable light. But if you've suddenly decided from showing a series of three small paintings to do a wall painting, then it will need negotiation with them. So do keep them informed. Unfortunately, I had a very bad experience with another exhibition, and which has prompted me to really stress the importance of getting everything in writing. This was a solo exhibition. I'm not going to name names, but it was a solo exhibition, and I was dealing with the gallery manager and the curator, primarily the curator. And having had meetings with both of them, I presumed that the curator and the gallery manager were talking to each other and were on good terms. I organised with the curator for a preview date, for a date for the opening of and a time, and arranged a band, and then did all of the press and the marketing and sent it out to all of the contacts that I've got, you know, announcements in what was then a Scottish Arts Council newsletter, on websites, etc., etc., to be told a week before the preview date that the gallery manager wasn't happy for the exhibition to open on that day. I went back to the curator. We confirmed this date, etc. Unfortunately, I had it in spoken terms that the curator had confirmed it with the gallery manager, but this wasn't in writing, and it meant that I had absolutely no rights whatsoever. So I just was incredibly embarrassed and had to write to all of the people that I contacted, put it in all of the newsletters again. Due to unforeseen circumstances, the preview date will now be on such and such a date. But that made, you know, that made me look really unprofessional, and it was not my fault whatsoever. I know now that I've done everything, but writing, and that's one lesson that I learned. And so even if you, you know, it's just an email to say, I confirm that it's fine for your preview date to be such and such, or I confirm that it's fine for you to install your own work, an email will say it, you know. Don't rely on someone telling it in your face. Also, just be open to opportunities to learn. It's inevitable that every exhibition you'll come across a different problem or something that you've not had to deal with before. For this exhibition that I was involved in, I got approached by a collector who wanted to buy all my work. Now, I've never had to think about how to sell video work before. You know, how do I copyright it? All of that kind of factors, suddenly I didn't know. But there's always people that you can ask, and that's really important. You don't have to have the answers now. You need to find them out, but there are people that you can ask to find them out. Jenny's a brilliant resource that as students that you have. You can ask other artists. AM magazine is really a resource. You know, the careers department will be able to advise you. I'll leave my contact details so I can always be asked. You know, there are ways, and that's a very nice thing to, you know, a collector coming and asking. That was a very nice thing for me to learn about. Equally, it can happen the other way, but just take it as it comes. No one's expecting you to know it all, but it does help. Well, for one, you've come here today, that shows that you're wanting to learn. You know, be open to that. I think that is, that's my presentation. But I'm happy to answer any questions. I have to scoot off now, but I'll be back at 5, so if you have any questions.